Hi everybody, it's Toby, and today something completely different. I want to show you my latest developments in OpenFOAM, and this is a foam analyzing tool. It's like a graphical user interface to allow you to check your OpenFOAM case and more deeply, especially I want to say regarding the numerics and your physical behavior of your numerical solution. So the guy we are talking about is here, and I just want to give you an idea what it will be, and you can look forward. I'm fucking happy that I started this program actually. I'm still happy. I recorded now half an hour about this program, and I was in pause mode of recording, so doesn't matter. I wanted to give you an idea about what I'm doing here, and you can maybe look forward for getting the guy testing it, and I will now let you know what it is for whom is it good for, and what it is the intention. So it's not a graphical user interface, like you are meshing here and things like this. It's more like a foam analyzer that you are, which allows you to control your open foam case more fundamental, that you get reliable analyses and numerical data. And I just jump in what it is, how it works, and foam def, foam 8. Let's go to foam 8, run. So nothing special, I just go to some tutorial which I prepared here. Heat transfer, Boolean, simple foam. Comfort hot room, so we just remove everything. So this is the case. So commonly we are executing it, and we get like the output of the solver, and yeah, that's it. You can now lock your output and do whatever you want with the data you get. Of course you can use GNU plot, so I was doing it all the time, so I have a lot of scripts and tools which allow me to analyze foam cases individually and very carefully. I mean the numerical data we get. However, I always forget to you know, add function objects which shows me the values, the minimum, maximum values, the average values, or something like this. And I also want to have a more, you know, user-friendly interface. I don't need it, but I have some colleagues who might have interest of something like this. So what it is, in order to use the tool, there is nothing special. We are just opening the graphic user interface. So unfortunately I cannot make it larger, so I just want to give you an idea about what it is actually. So the foam analyzer will support you actually in, let's say, setting up numerics and also checking, you know, very, very common mistakes one does. So for example, I have here these check boundary conditions not yet implemented, but it will compare that you have the correct boundary patch types and the correct, let's say, boundary for each quantity, the boundary we are using these types. So for example, in the constant polymesh boundary, you have defined some surface as a wall, then you should define, for example, a wall function for the turbulence model for this stuff, and this will, you know, support you that you are not missing something. Or a common problem I have a wall first, and then I say it's a patch. Something can go in, something can go out. I start the calculation, and then I get like an error. Oh, well, you have applied wall functions on a patch, which is not, you cannot do that. So this will just, you know, make things a bit easier that you check, okay, things are working fine here, or do I have like some general problem in my boundary conditions and boundary patch type combination. So nothing special. I'm even not sure if I will implement something like this. However, I will also check, make something we can think about adding, like we check the mesh, and based on the output of the quality of the mesh, we give some information to the user. Hey, well, you have a highly non-orthogonal mesh, and you use for the Laplace and surface normal gradient scheme, you use an orthogonal scheme. Hey, please use some corrected or some limited one, so like some hints, you know, for people who are not so familiar with this the stuff. Okay, so this guy is not yet finished and has a lot of bugs. So what we do actually is we start our solver. Of course, we can go here to run, and I will not explain everything. I will maybe make a license out of that, I'm not sure. So we will see, but it will be, you know, as always, very cheap. So this is actually the main page we are interested in right now. So I just started, and foam analyzer, this will be automatically somewhere, of course, and we start the solver. So of course it will do the same when I click here, but it's not yet implemented, so forget about that. And I'll also stop and save, which will not kill the simulation but do it more smoothly, like finish the last iteration or time step, save it, and something like this. Okay, so log is clear. We can check out the log file here. Nothing special, as you can also go to the log file in the terminal, but I just wanted to add it somehow into this guy. Now the more interesting things. So we can check out the residuals, you know, live and without having foam monitor or other tools, GNUplot. Of course, you can use GNUplot and you can make scripts, and I have them all to analyze the stuff. But I really like this way more. So you can check out, hey, how are my velocity residuals? How are the final residuals of my linear solver? Yes. Do I reach already the limits I set in the FV solutions here? Commonly it's 1.-6, or do we have here some space? Of course, we will also linear solve iteration, like the number of iterations we need. We can do this for turbulence too. So just ignore this one. The colors, of course, can be changed somewhere. Pressure, I don't know why it's gray, but you can also check the pressure, and you see, okay, we are converging, we are not converging. So for the energy, the same. Also for the continuity, how is the continuity working here? Yes, maybe the colors, and here, you know, it's still buggy, a lot of things to do. But you see, do I have like a flat line parallel to the x-axis, or do I have, you know, cumulation of error, something like this. So like getting an hint about how is your simulation actually working, and how is the guy. You see, I cannot go back here, doesn't matter. Still in progress. So but the more interesting things is, we will have like temperature, pressure, velocity, also later on turbulence or something like that. We can analyze the fields. So how is actually the temperature in our domain? How are the min and maximum temperatures? How is the average temperature in the domain? And, you know, I also added for our French guys directly here, grad Fahrenheit. which is, you know, easy to use, and it will directly give you an idea. So, well, you say, no, sorry, we have 30, we have over 30 degree here. No, it's not possible. So please limit. Okay, I get here an error. Doesn't matter. We are just restarting the guys. Let's just do it again. I know there is some problem here. I still have to do something here. However, you see you can directly limit the things, and it is working. So I have to wait a few seconds until I can remove the limit, and you see it is going up again. So you directly see the influence of limiting things, and you directly have the idea what's going on in my case. Of course, the same for the pressure. So how's the pressure in my domain? So I see here the minimum pressure, maximum, the average pressure. Sometimes you have the situation that your boundary conditions provide something like you suck more in out of your domain than you bring in. So the pressure is decreasing gradually, and you don't see it if you check out the log files. And it's sometimes also not easy to figure out, or let's say in an easy way to figure out why is the case crashing. And this directly gives you a hint, oh, something is wrong, my pressure is increasing or decreasing, so why? And then you can go checking here, continuity. Okay, so we have like a accumulation, you directly see like the relation between this and also the velocity. You can check what is my actual velocity here. So we have 0.58 meter per second. You say, sorry, I want to limit it to 0.4. The question is, I'm not sure why it is not working right now. So maybe I have an idea, but this is some problem regarding development and programming, and how OpenFOAM is using something like this, especially rereading the files. So as you see, it works here. We have 0.78, and you say, I'm sorry, I want to have 0.4, and then it is reduced. However, you see it's not reduced to 0.4. This is actually related to the fact how foam is limiting the velocity, so you cannot just cut everything, it will break the continuity. You see, this is working. I will also add, like, you know, turbulence properties to check what is K, what is omega, what is epsilon doing, or some other fields. Also, you have here the species, and this is like interactive. So if there is no energy, you will not be able to click on this energy. So and then you can stop save and doing something like this. So this is like the main key of this foam analyzer tool, that you directly can, you know, check what's going on in my domain, how are the max and min values, so you can have an action on that using, you know, limit velocity, limit temperature, also limit pressure if the solver allows it. For example, you directly see how is the residual stuff. And I also want to implement, you know, here directly that you can change the numerical schemes, upwind, second order, you know, limiter or whatever. I think I will not add all the whole list, but more probably like a few, that you have like an idea what is going on with my solution if I change something like here, for example, the divergence schemes, or if we are using a normal second order gradient scheme, or if you are using a limited gradient scheme, or if you're using for the gradient the least square method. It will directly act here in the graphic user interface as a direct feedback. And I think this is like a tool which is still missing somehow in the out there, right? So it's not an user interface for setting up your case. It's more like an user interface of, hey, what the fuck, my simulation is crashing and I want to know why, and this will probably give you an instrument of getting rid of your problems by analyzing the data we can get out of OpenFOAM. Of course, you can do everything your own. That's not a big deal. You can use functions or function objects, FV options, and whatever OpenFOAM offers us. However, this is like, you know, a combined thing that everything is in. Okay, it's not everything, but it will, you know, it's nice to have. So actually, I'm very happy that I started doing something like this, because it, even if it's buggy right now, it is helping me really. And the question is how I'm like a general setup, or if I'm implementing this. But it is like just an idea how I am doing now the analysis of my OpenFOAM cases, how I get rid of problems I have. And yeah, that's it. I just wanted to keep you informed. Of course, I will need a few days, weeks more in making progress here, but I think right now I'm at a level just to give you an idea what I'm doing right now, in addition to all the other things I'm doing. And I hope that this guy will support your work someone. And of course, we will see how we manage to bring it to you, and how I can get some benefit out of the hours I spent developing something like this. There will be, I promise, like a training or a supporting the testing phase, I won't say, of a beta release, which I will announce at YouTube and on LinkedIn and Twitter. So someone, this date is reached, stay tuned not to miss it, that you can have access to the toolbox, that you can check the toolbox, that you can, yeah, do whatever you want with the toolbox and figure out, will it support the community, or is it just another user interface no one is using? I will use it definitely, because it will give me more insight into this stuff. So 70 minutes, below 20. That's everything. Guys, keep foaming, keep up your hard work, and thank you for watching and subscribe. Please share my work. I see all the time that I'm doing so much things and I have so less views. Doesn't matter. I hope this video was interesting for you. See you guys, I think, in some other video. Bye bye, goodbye, and take care, guys.